Hello Space Cats and welcome back to my channel. This week I was gifted this special piece of rock from my mentor Bruno Altieri. It's a Martian meteorite that was discovered in 2017 in Mauritania, Northwest Africa. This specific piece is a shergotite and it's the most common type of Martian meteorite found on the Earth. It's likely to have formed on the surface of Mars, close to lava flows. So this week's video, I'm going to be talking about some of the weird and wonderful things found on Mars. Lava tubes are volcanic caverns that are formed by flowing lava. On Earth, the longest lava tube is the Kazamura cave in Hawaii, and that spans 65 kilometers in length, about the same distance from London to Cambridge. And they can typically grow as wide as 30 meters in size as well. But on Mars, they can grow much larger because the gravity on Mars is a third of that here on Earth. On Mars, the lava tubes can be as large as 250 meters in width. That's 8 times wider than the lava tubes we have here on Earth. Currently, our rovers are too large and too clunky to go exploring the lava tubes on Mars. So we don't really know what's hiding in there. Could it be extraterrestrials? Or they could even harbor liquid water. But what's really important is that these spaces could offer great protection for future astronaut settlements from radiation. Seasonal flows are mysterious lines that appear and disappear with the seasons on the surface of Mars. Scientists aren't quite sure exactly what is causing these events. However, one of the theories is that it could be flowing water caused by ice melt. Specifically, it could be brine, aka salty water. There's another theory, however, that it's a dry avalanche, and this could be caused when boiling liquids on the surface of Mars is tossing sand grains all about and causing this avalanche. On Earth, our skies are blue and our sunsets are red, and this is due to molecules in the Earth's atmosphere that scatter red light from the sun the least. On the contrary, on Mars, the opposite happens. They have red skies and blue sunsets. And this is partly due to the same reason that gives Mars its characteristic red color. So Mars is red because the surface soil is mostly iron oxide, aka rust. And these same particles fill the entire atmosphere of Mars. It's an incredibly dusty planet. And these dust particles tend to scatter red light the most, and that allows the blue light to pass through, giving them their blue sunset. Swirling columns of wind and dust, known as dust devils, occur very frequently on Mars. And whilst we also have similar things here on Earth that can grow as high as a kilometer in height, on Mars, they can be as high as Mount Everest. Not only that, but every 6 years or so, Mars has a global dust storm, which covers the entire planet with a thick dust. These can last like months or more, and it allows little or even no sunlight at all to reach the surface. It's during times like these that the Martian rovers will go into hibernation. These are Bluegreen. They're scattered all over the surface of Mars, and they're essentially iron-rich spherical rocks. So this is the part where you expect me to talk about that time in 2014 when NASA's Opportunity rover saw this rock. It wasn't there 13 days earlier. But actually, what's more strange about these blueberries are that they're incredibly smooth, and that's only something that you would expect if they had moved through large bodies of water, or even acidic water. Recently, whilst listening out for seismic quakes, NASA's InSight rover recorded the following sound. Thank you. Scientists believe that this eerie whistling, the dinks and the doinks, are caused by the wind on Mars and an instrument on board that is expanding and contracting as it heats up and cools down. This kind of makes sense because it happens just after sunset. However, I'm not sure that I'm quite convinced. The last puzzling thing about Mars is the fact that the northern hemisphere is extremely smooth, whereas the southern hemisphere is extremely cratered. Some scientists believe that all of Mars used to be heavily cratered, but that lava flows, water flow, and dust storms smoothed it out. But then why didn't it also smooth out the southern hemisphere? There's another theory that Mars used to be a moon around another planet, and that planet exploded, leaving half of Mars heavily cratered. But who knows? This is still an unsolved mystery. There are so many more strange things about Mars. For example, the appearing and disappearing of methane, which is typically a sign of life, the unspherical and very tiny moons, the brain terrain, and the fact that it has an aurora, but it doesn't have a magnetic field. But that's all that I've got time to talk about now. Let me know in the comment section below what you think is the most puzzling thing about Mars. And as usual, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave me a like, share, and subscribe.